Never Stop Sneakin is a top-down stealth action game that revels in the fact that it's a big ol' love letter to Metal Gear Solid, particularly Metal Gear Solid 1. The chunky PlayStation 1 graphics are recreated beautifully, and I say that without a hint of sarcasm. I've always preferred the look of Solid Snake in that game because his expressions and the finer details of how his face actually looks were left entirely up to your imagination. That's probably why I could never find an action figure that looked right to me. Anyways, what I'm saying is that I've always had a fondness for this look, and in a way what was originally a compromise due to hardware limitations has kind of become an art style in and of itself. Splashes of highly saturated color pop off the screen, while the jagged pixelation adds a gritty texture that stops the environment from feeling too cartoony. Games that look this way are kind of a lost art, you know, that they're a relic of the PlayStation 1 era, and personally, I would love to see more of it, but maybe that's just me.
But first things first, Agent. Before we start, you'll need to clear a training program. Let's go.
As you play through the game, you'll unlock a variety of playable characters and weapons that serve as costumes, ranging from ninjas to secret agents to construction workers and even helicopters. No, really, you can be a helicopter with a sword and a gun. It's awesome. Never Stop Sneakin' doesn't shy away from referencing other entries in the Metal Gear Solid franchise either. From recreating Naked Snake's Halo drop from Metal Gear Solid 3 in its intro, to recording their very own take on the Snake Eater theme. Never Stop Sneakin'. As far as I'm concerned, the music in this game is the star of the show. I cannot believe how much this sounds like an original soundtrack from Harry Gregson Williams. These tracks would be right at home in any Metal Gear Solid game after Sons of Liberty. This is some really impressive work. The music, of course, is complemented by a solid cast of voice actors, including Mr. Metal Gear Awesome himself, Aaron Hansen, as Major Milestone. The game's sense of humor is unapologetically silly, and while it never had me laughing out loud, it did get a chuckle out of me here and there. Never Stop Sneakin knows what it is, and it handles its tone gracefully.
16 hours ago, I used a time machine to kidnap the presidents, even the bad ones.
Now, in spite of the endearing aesthetic, excellent soundtrack, and tongue-in-cheek sense of humor, unfortunately where the game begins to disappoint is in its gameplay. Remember when I said at the beginning of this video that this was a stealth game? That's actually wrong. Yeah, you've got vision cones, and you wait for enemies to turn around so you can take them out. There are security cameras, EMP grenades, and flashbangs, and all the stuff that on the surface makes this seem like a stealth game. But sneaking by simply isn't your goal here. And to me, the joy of playing a stealth game comes from using the gameplay mechanics available to solve the puzzle of how you get by an enemy unnoticed. This doesn't need to be all that complicated either. The option to simply knock on a wall to lure an enemy over is an excellent example. That's somehow missing in this game. In fact, Never Stop Sneaking is so basic that upon starting the tutorial, you'll quickly realize that the entire game is played with this. Just this. Aside from standing still to unlock doors or hack computers, the only gameplay mechanic in here is attacking. You attack everything. See, you need to collect what the game calls espionage points, or ESP. It's the currency of the game, and it's sprinkled across every stage, it's tucked into lockers, computers, and bursts out of bosses when you beat them. To take an enemy out with your sword, you just walk into them without them seeing you. If you are spotted by them, you automatically shoot them, provided you have the ammo in your clip. If you get spotted by a camera, your EMP goes off automatically. If you don't have any of these safety nets in your inventory, you'll lose a heart, run out of hearts, and you get kicked out of the mission. So this is how you play the game. Not by controlling how these tools are used, but by navigating your character to a position where they will trigger these actions automatically. It's just not very compelling for long-term play. Instead, it's better suited for short, casual play sessions. In a lot of ways, Never Stop Sneakin' feels like a mobile game that has been ported to consoles. Is it a coincidence that it can be played entirely on your touchscreen, and all the buttons and menus are strangely large, making them easy to tap with your finger? I don't know. What I do know is that I would totally play this on an iPad. And don't get me wrong, it's not that I have anything against mobile games. It's just that when you've got competition like SteamWorld Dig, or Golf Story, or Mutant Muds, or Sonic Mania, all on the Nintendo eShop, it's a tough sell. You see, while the game may have Metal Gear references coming out of its eyeballs, and even emphasize sneaking in its title, it actually plays more like an arcade-style bullet hell game than anything else. You navigate your way through levels, trying to weave in between danger in the form of your enemies' lines of sight, and take them out while collecting points as quickly as possible so that you get the most out of your combo multiplier. Rinse and repeat until you've collected enough points to afford the next base upgrade. Oh, and by the way, the base building system is another neat Metal Gear Solid reference. Shout out to Peace Walker and MGS5. After every couple floors, you'll face off against one of the same handful of bosses over and over again. I will say that these bosses are well designed. The first time you face them, they're actually pretty interesting considering the few mechanics you have to play with. It's probably no coincidence that the most interesting boss fight is what they show you in the tutorial. But yeah, I mean, they're not bad, they just repeat them over and over again. Now, I've been really negative here, but I don't want you to think I dislike this game. I'm not mad, I'm just disappointed. You see, this was a game that I've been highly anticipating since the announcement trailer in October. One look at that trailer and I had to have it. Even my friends knew. And to be honest, after a few hours of playing and accepting it for what it really was, I finally started to enjoy myself. The further into the game you get, the more dangerous and populated levels become. Missions get longer and longer, raising the stakes and making death a whole lot more devastating. And after grinding away at it for so long, you kind of zone out and are almost on autopilot, clearing crowded rooms effortlessly while raking in points and keeping your combo going. It's the same feeling you might get while playing one of those really intense, high-score chasing arcade shooters. Think Geometry Wars, Resogun, and the like. And in that regard, the game absolutely succeeds in what it's doing, even though it takes a little too long to ramp up the difficulty. So I hope you understand what I mean when I say the game left me a little bit disappointed. Even if you set aside my preconceived notion of what this game was going to be, the fact that playing it for hours on end will consist of the same 4 or 5 themes slapped onto a handful of randomly generated environments is too bad. And by the 20th time that you start a mission and this guy is the first thing you see, you'll really start to notice just how repetitive the algorithm can get. The progression system that comes in the form of adding new structures to your base, which adds perks to the in-game store and occasionally comes with new costumes, is a great way to keep players hammering away at missions. But I would have appreciated it if the game provided more context behind why the mission I'm going on takes place in a forest, a cave, a facility, or airship. As it is, there's no rhyme or reason to it, and it's too bad because something as simple as the Major telling you that the person you're rescuing is being held here or there would have been enough. As it is, it all just seems arbitrary. In conclusion, Never Stop Sneakin is a bit uneven. The visuals are charming, the music is top-notch, there's a playful sense of humor that you can't help but smile at, there's fun skins to unlock and play with, but at its core, the most important factor, the gameplay, needed a little bit more complexity. Even just a way to lure enemies towards you would have been a game changer. Nevertheless, I did have fun with the game, and I'm giving it a 3 out of 5.